Welcome to today's video. I have some super fun new launches from Anastasia Beverly Hills to talk about. I have the Riviera Palette, the new eyeshadow primer, and the new loose highlighter in Snowflake. In honor of the Riviera Palette, I did have to wear a fun little top knot and my resort wear white. And that seemed like a much better idea before I started filming a tutorial on crazy bright summer colors. So let's hope I don't end up with a rainbow resort wear white outfit when I'm done with this. So to be real about this Riviera palette, when I first saw the launch and I saw everything on Instagram and online about it, I told myself I was not going to buy the palette. Which to me, not buying an Anastasia Beverly Hills palette is like sacrilege. I have three of them right here. They're some of my favorites. I have too many of her eyeshadow singles to count. I think her eyeshadow formula is amazing. The color payoff is always great. When it came to this guy, these colors just looked so crazy and out there. I couldn't justify adding this to my collection because I didn't feel like I would get as much use out of it as I do from some of the more neutral palettes. But as I always do, I found myself in Sephora swatching this little baby, and the swatches were so yummy. I couldn't stop myself from buying it. I had to. And I'm gonna swatch some of those colors for you. In my favorite summer finds video, I did swatch a couple, but I'm gonna do a few more today. So the matte shades are all pretty true to color. I believe these three, the pink, the purple, and the brown, are actually pressed pigments. They do say to wear an eyeshadow primer or some sort of base under the pink and the purple because they are pressed pigments. There is a high possibility they will stain their skin, but for anyone who uses pink eyeshadow quite often or even probably has ever used pink eyeshadow before, you know there's always a high probability that it's going to stain your skin. So just be careful with that. Let's start with this white, Yacht, Seychelles, and Palermo. Followed by Seaside, Inheritance, and Mediterranean. So pretty. I am gonna go ahead and swatch Bahamas, Tan, and Palm, the three pressed pigments we talked about. My thoughts on the pressed pigments. You can see how creamy all of these shades are, even the pink, but the purple and the brown did not swatch well. And I had heard that from other reviews, that they're really buildable and you need to take time to blend them and just be careful with them because they are pressed pigments and not pure shadows. So just take note on those two colors that they may need a little extra love. Now, when I went in and did my crease, which you'll see in the video, I did use Palm just in the very outside corner and I did not have that problem. I don't mind it at all, but like I said, it just did not swatch very well. Now there is something weird that I noticed in this palette that I haven't noticed in my other Anastasia shadows before, so I'm gonna swatch some from the other three palettes and see if they do the same thing. It's especially apparent in Palermo and Seaside, but I feel as I've swatched them, I really moved the pigment around in the pan almost like they're putty. You can see how it's been kind of smushed. In Norvina, I'm gonna go into Dazzling. It looks like it has kind of a similar formula. Oh yeah, that did it too. Okay, lesson learned, swatch lightly. I guess I just have to learn not to be so strong. I'm gonna take a minute to clean up my mess here before I get it all over my clothes and I will be right back. In today's look, I am wearing Cabana, Coastline, Palm, Mediterranean, and Inheritance. And now it's time for my tutorial on this look, followed by my final thoughts on these new products. To start off, I'm gonna take the new Anastasia eyeshadow primer. I have the mini here. I didn't wanna buy the full size until I knew if I really liked it or not, so I'm gonna try it with the little mini guy. I did see in some videos that this is a lot more pigmented and opaque than my paint pot that I normally use. So it looks like it has more of a concealer consistency than what I'm used to. So we will see. I just put a little bit on my hand here, and it's actually a little bit thinner than I expected it to be. I'm gonna go in with a brush into the eyeshadow primer that is on my hand. Dance break! Okay, so that did go on a lot thinner than I expected it to be. I expected it to be very thick. It went on very thin, not watery, but thin. And it is a lot lighter than I'm used to. You can tell that there definitely is some lighter pigment to this. I will say I do feel like it has creased in my eyelids a little bit. I have mentioned multiple times on my channel and my blog that I do have kind of crepey, wrinkly eyelids. So product does tend to settle into my eyelids. And I do feel like this has really enhanced the texture in my lid. So I'm not sure how I feel about it yet, but we are going to cover that up with shadow. So maybe it'll all work out. I'm going to go in with my bigger fluffy crease brush for my transition shade, and I am going to use Cabana. I was worried at first that this was going to turn a bit of a mustard kind of yellow brown on me because that's what it looked like when I first put it on, but it did blend out very nicely. Even though that was a transition shade and I'm usually a little bit more free-spirited with my transition application than I am with the rest of my shadows, I did not notice any creasing or anything crazy with the primer or the eyeshadow formula. Next, I am going to go all over my crease, a more full crease, not a tight crease, with Coastline, which is a very pretty apricot peach. I think I want a little bit more peach in my shadow, so I'm gonna pull that up just a little bit. Next, I am going to go in just the outer corners, just a touch with Palm, this brown right here. Now for the part that I am most excited about, I am going to go all over my lid with Mediterranean, which is this gorgeous blue. Now I'm gonna go back in with my brush that has the peachy color on it. I'm not gonna add more pigment, but I am going to lightly buff that edge to blend everything together. Last, I am going to go into Inheritance, which is this really fun gold. And you could go in with your finger in the inner corner of the eye. I'm going to go in with a brush. I just like brushes better. I'm going to go back in with the brush that had Mediterranean, our blue, and I'm just going to kind of pat the edge of that to make sure that it looks blended. And I did like the way that it looked with bringing the gold a little bit up into the arch to fade into that peach, so I'm just gonna make sure that that's blended on both sides. And I'm gonna go in with a trusty makeup wipe, clean up my fallout. I know that Anastasia's shadows are very pigmented and do tend to have a bit of a fallout on me. They are very soft. Maybe I'm a little more vicious with my brushes than some people, I don't know. But I always tend to have a lot of fallout with these shadows, so I always do my eyes first. Water break. I really love how this is turning out. It's almost like a sunrise, sunset over the ocean. I love it. So my thoughts on the primer. I think the primer did a great job. We obviously covered all of it with shadows. So the thoughts that I had on the pigmentation and the density of the primer didn't end up mattering in the end. I do feel like my eyelids have a bit of texture, but they always have a bit of texture, so that's not the primer's fault. The overall formula of these shadows, Anastasia does it again. They are wonderful. They're soft and buttery. They blended so well using all of these crazy colors together and making it look like a cohesive look. I'm gonna go in with some eyeliner, foundation, blush, and bronzer, and I will be right back. Okay, I did all the things I mentioned earlier, and now I'm back onto the Anastasia Loose Highlight in Snowflake. This does come in three colors. Snowflake is the lightest. It's a little bit more of a white, clear color versus champagne or gold. As a more cool toned person, I tend to go more for pearl white lavender highlights than a champagne gold more yellowy highlight. So after opening, there's not any product that's out here that we can actually pick up. So I'm gonna close this and shake it a little bit. It does make me a little bit nervous because I have no idea how much is going to be in here now. Oh, not much came out at all. That's nice. This looks like a lot on my brush, but we will find out. Oh man, that's a highlight. It is definitely a glitter highlight, not a sparkle or shimmer highlight. There is actual glitter flecks on my face. The one thing that I don't like is that it doesn't blend out super well because it is such a powerful glitter. So I'm just gonna take a big fluffy brush and kind of fade those edges a little bit. I will say this will not be my new everyday highlight. I am not usually a fan of glitter highlights for every day, but definitely for a fun occasion or something more glamorous, this is very nice. Last step, mascara. Puppy break. Oh, you like it? You like my look? What do you think? And a little setting spray. I'm kind of loving it. This is so much more color than I normally wear, as I'm wearing white. Don't judge. But here's the part I know you really want to know. Do you spend, do you splurge, or do you save? As for the eyeshadow primer, if you do not have an eyeshadow primer that you already use, I would recommend this primer. I didn't feel a lot of skipping as I put on my shadow, and I felt like everything did stick. Obviously, it'll take a few hours to find out if it's truly a longer wear product, if it helped everything stick. I did think it helped everything blend. Nothing really got stuck to it or skipped or had any application issues. I will say this is a lot of product in this mini. I don't know how big the full size is, but I think it would take you a long time to go through this mini. So I would buy the mini. My thoughts on this palette are kind of torn. It is $3 more expensive than the other three Anastasia palettes that I have that are all currently selling for $42. Okay, that's a lie. These two are selling for $42. This one's no longer available. It was holiday. Sorry guys, it's really pretty. Like I said, I was not going to buy this palette, but I swatched it in store and I just fell in love with it. But what I do have to say about this is that you can find a lot of these colors in other places. For example, ColourPop has this amazing Super Shock shadow in this gorgeous pink. And I know it's not the exact same pink, but if you're looking for a hot pink shadow, you can pay $6 for this guy or $45 for the entire palette. It does come with a lot of great colors, but if you're only wanting one or two of them, it's a much better bet to go buy something else where you can buy individual shadows or a smaller palette that's not $45. However, if you are just getting started expanding your collection, you don't have a lot of color, you don't have any of these colors in any other palette or products in your collection, this is a really good pick. You get all of these colors, you can make so many looks. I do feel like for some of the looks, you'll have to bring in colors from other palettes, maybe like a lighter purple or a shimmer purple, a lighter pink, a darker blue, things that you would want in your crease or in the inner corner to really lighten up or deepen a look. There's just not a lot of variation insofar as depth of color story in this guy. But if you are really big on color, you want some wild and crazy looks, you just want something trendy for summer, this is really great. I love everything Anastasia does. Last up, the loose highlighter. I don't feel like I'm really sold on this product. It swatches gorgeously. It's nice on, but it's just not every day. Like, I can't see myself walking through Target with glitter highlight. If I had something really fun to go do, a special occasion, yes, but I feel like the amount of product that you get in here, it would just sit in my makeup drawer and I don't feel like I would use it enough to make it worth it. So if you are a glitter highlight person, if you live by a beach, if you do lots of fun things during the summer, this is fantastic. If you're just an everyday girl that wants a nice highlighter, I think there are other options out there. Okay guys, that's all I have for you today. I appreciate you being here with me. I love being here with you guys. If you had fun fun hanging out with me, hit the like button, subscribe, ring the bell so you know when I put up new videos. Leave in the comments below if there's something you want to see, questions you have, anything you want to tell me. Let me know what you guys think of the Riviera palette and the other products we looked at today. Let me know your thoughts on this sunrise, sunset look, and I will see you next time.